In this video, I'm gonna show you what a lower thirds graphic is and how to make one for your videos. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. Making a video is oftentimes about getting information to the viewer quickly and clearly. You can use lower third graphics to help establish new people or add information. You've most likely seen lower thirds graphics before on news broadcasts or even earlier in this episode. Lower thirds reinforce information on screen that you may have already said out loud, such as your name, or to give even more information like a job title. It's referred to as a lower third for the obvious reason, that it sits in the lower third of your screen. Stylistically, lower thirds graphics can be designed however you want, but the purpose of the graphic is to serve the video by presenting information. So we want to make sure that any lower thirds graphics we make are clear to read and don't distract from other important information in the video. You don't want viewers reading when they're supposed to be watching another clip, for example. Let's take a look at some examples of lower third graphics that just don't work. In our first example, the text was too small and the graphic went by too fast for our audience to read it. This would be easy to fix by having our graphic stay on longer and making our text larger and easier to read. In videos, more often than not, a sans serif font, one that doesn't have the little swirls or tails on the letters, will be easier to read for most people on most screens. Not a rule, just a tip in case you're looking for the clearest result. Let's look at another one. In this second example, our graphic's too big with colors that distract from what's happening in the video. You can solve it just as easily by shrinking the graphic and making sure that the colors complement the colors in your video. If you aren't sure which colors to use, try going with a semi-transparent gray or black. That style goes with almost anything. Then add bright text on top and you should be all set. Now that we have some good principles for making a lower thirds graphic, let's hop into Camtasia and make one. There's a link in the description for a free trial if you want to follow along. In Camtasia, I have my video already edited. Go to the Annotations tab and choose one you like. If you don't find one that fits your video, you can always click Download More Assets to go to the TechSmith Assets for Camtasia online library where you'll find tons of pre-made lower thirds if you aren't sure where to start, or maybe just aren't feeling creative and need a quick solution. For now, I'll use the white square, but you can choose whichever you think fits best. Drag and drop the graphic onto your video. You can click and drag any of the little circles or handles around your graphic to resize it. To move the entire graphic down into the corner, let's click and drag the middle circle with the X. Now, double-click on the text to edit it. Add your new text. In the Properties panel, we can change the text size and color. Once we're happy with this, we can click on the Annotations tab and pull up the properties of our graphic. Change the color and opacity until you're satisfied. Let's add an animation to finish this off. Click on the Transitions tab and you can see what your options are. There are a lot of transitions you can use. Feel free to try out a few and see what you like. For this video, I'm going to use the Slide Right transition as it's a pretty standard lower thirds animation. By the way, if you haven't checked them out, Behaviors also have some fun ways of bringing in objects in Camtasia. Feel free to play around. Drag and drop your transition onto the beginning of your lower thirds graphic. Most of the work should be done for us already, but we still need to tweak the timing. Down on the timeline, we can see our transition on the front of our graphic. Grab the edge of that transition to drag it back to make our animation longer. This may take a couple of tries to get it right, but keep adjusting until you get it. Once you have your first transition, drag and drop another one on the back of the graphic and repeat the same process. That's it. Lower thirds are a simple but really effective way of communicating important information to your audience. If you learned something today, give this video a like. And if you're curious to learn more, go ahead and hit the subscribe button to be alerted when we post more tips and tricks for your videos. Thanks for watching.